In this video, we expand our product line for our virtual print-on-demand store, FamPrints. You know, there seems to be a common question floating around, and that is, should I sell something like this or even this right here? Other people seem to be doing it successfully, and there's dozens of listings on Etsy for it. So that must be what I should be able to sell. So I am in the process of ordering a few more of these posters we talked about in the last video. I'm talking with the designer on Fiverr right now, and he just delivered the final results, and they look really, really nice. I'm really happy about this. He's super, super fast. Anyways, I received this comment from Zachariah, and he's getting into print on demand. He's essentially asking, hey, you gave this example with pop socks in the last video. Would it be a good idea to go out there and sell something similar? And you know, if I was just getting into e-commerce for the first time, I would think, yeah, you know, that sounds like the wise thing to do. We're following other people's success. However, after doing this for a few years, I would actually advise against it. You see, with pop socks, they have spent millions on ads the last few years and have essentially saturated the market with their custom pet socks. Now, saturation does not mean you can't build a profitable business selling those. It does, however, mean it's going to be much harder.
To sell online in 2019 and 2020, and to do it profitably over the long term, it's absolutely key to be original. So back to the idea of pop socks, they're not the first promoting these. We have this store, this store, this store, this store, and this store in a sea of dozens of other stores, and they're all promoting the same thing.
And no, these are not fly-by-the-night stores. Divvy Up right here has actually done millions in sales and was actually one of the first to introduce this product, and these other stores followed their success and had done millions in sales combined. Now imagine how hard it would be to go out there and sell what they're selling with their already established ad budgets and be consistently profitable.
The beauty with print on demand is that you are the creative CEO. It's not like China dropshipping where you're stuck selling somebody else's product. With POD, we have full control as far as what we promote, how the design looks, so why not take full advantage of that?
Yes, we want to follow the success of others, but replicating something that's been overly promoted is going to hinder our progress toward creating a really amazing business doing really amazing numbers. We're in a very saturated market, but we'll probably do about $10 million by the end of this year. Just yesterday, $12,800 in sales, and we can get away with it because we were one of the first in this category selling this specific product back when we started in 2017. I think there was two other people doing what we're doing now. We decided to jump into it because we knew that we could do it better and climbed our way up to the top.
When we look at our custom posters, there are a ton of sellers on Etsy selling it. But that doesn't really matter to me right now. I'm more concerned about who's building a brand advertising this product. And in that case, I found one big player, Turned Yellow. I made an order on their website and was order number 23,600. Now I'm betting that it is an accurate Shopify order number and counts up from 1,000. So I'll times 22,600 by an estimated AOV of $48. And that leaves me with just over $1 million in estimated revenue. And after looking at the Wayback Machine, it looks like they've been in business since 2017. And I'm not going to lie, I like what they have going on here. I've even seen some of their ads on Facebook. They seem to have a very engaged customer base. So for FamPrints, this was our product of choice for ads in the last video, despite Turned Yellow being into the picture. What was my thought process behind this, and would it be wise to differentiate the product? Well, we'll come back to this question. First, I want to go back to the example of pup socks. What would I do? If product saturation has been determined, I'll come up with a USP, or unique selling proposition, which separates you from everybody else. For example, in the online teeth whitening industry, there are two big players right now, High Smile and Snow Teeth Whitening. High Smile is known for its cost-efficient product, while Snow Teeth Whitening is essentially the Apple of oral care. Expanding on their USP, High Smile has a huge focus on branding. I love these guys. I mean, just look at how creative they are. And Snow Teeth Whitening, they put a large focus on celebrity partnerships.
When it comes to saturation, you can either decide to sell the product as is and come up with a USP, or go with a different similar product. And I usually like to go with the B option, find a different product unless I'm really confident in what I'm looking at and I can make it better. And I'm gonna show you on Facebook these unique ads I found pertaining to the dog niche like Zachariah mentioned. And I know they're really unique because after doing some research, I've discovered that they have really
really only been mass promoted these last few months. This dog mat right here, super, super interesting. Lots of engagement on the ad, 32,000 likes. And if we go over to Etsy, dozens and dozens of sellers that have been selling it. But only recently have I started to actually see this on Facebook. Next, we have this quilt right here, which I thought was really cool, picture of the dog. And you can customize the text that is on the blanket as well. Blankets, quilts are very, very popular when it comes to print on demand. And finally, we have this custom canvas. You can't really see it, but this custom canvas of the dog in the suit. And only recently, within these last few months, I've seen this become really popular with like the different dogs on canvases, different like royalty suits and stuff like that. And if we go over to Etsy, there are dozens of sellers specializing in this and have been specializing in for years, but only recently has it started to blow up on Facebook. I mean, these people have gotten into a saturated market and took the route of going unique, going more unique. Now, when it comes to pub socks and say that we wanted to sell what they're selling, we were determined to sell these socks. Well, obviously we would come up with a USP to increase our chances of higher profitability and consistent sales. Now, these are some ideas that I came up with if we decided to do that. So first off, we can try promoting blankets or other products besides the side. There's so many other products we can do besides socks. So B, have more interesting backgrounds. These backgrounds are very, very generic. They're all kind of using the same ones. What if we use like a background with apples on it or a background with, I don't know, food on it. Number three, work with large influencers. Not even large influencers, but influencers in general. These companies, they're not really working with any kind of big influencers out there, and I'm not sure how effective it would be, but when you work with an influencer and you tie an influencer to your brand, it's so much more powerful. I mean, think about Snow Teeth Whitening and High Smile. Those two brands are separated from everybody else because of their celebrity partnerships. So everybody goes to them, everybody knows that they're legit, and use those in our ads and our emails and show people, hey, we're the real deal, we are different.
So for our custom posters, after looking on Facebook and Google, doing my research, my determination is there isn't saturation. However, it's probably a smaller market that we'd be appealing to. I'll sell this poster as is, innovate along the way, offering similar product options as the listings on Etsy and Turned Yellow.
So with all of this in mind and the right way to go about finding unique products, I added three more to the list for FamPrints.
First, I added this to the list. After doing some research, I discovered that these royal pet canvases are really popular in the dog niche. So there's so many stores right now jumping on the trend. So with that in mind, I did a few searches and found something similar in the home niche. Next, I added this custom Instagram frame. I'm not really sure why, it just really stuck out to me and it looks really cool. I'd have to find a way to work with this manufacturer privately. And finally, this custom portrait here. It's very generic and I definitely would make some tweaks, but inspiration came from this Facebook ad. I've noticed that these guys have been blowing the product up, but not to the point of saturation. So why not do something similar, but better, and hone in on that USP?
I so anxiously await the day that FamPrints goes mainstream.
Let's recap everything we've talked about. If evidence for a product you want to promote points to saturation, you must develop a USP to differentiate. This will allow you to be way more profitable and get way more sales if you do it correctly and you're really onto something. I'm in the process of building a new store right now, and the way that I'm differentiating is, well, how can I describe this? Okay, think of this birth poster right here, and it did really, really well for somebody else, so I decided to jump in with a little bit different of a design and product line in a totally different niche.
Alright guys, that's all I have for you in this video, and I'm curious, was it helpful? Let me know down in the comment section below, and I want to remind you once again that Q4 is coming. It's literally upon us. We're a month away. I'm already having trouble sleeping at night just anticipating it and being so excited for it. Now is the best time to start a store. Do not wait until next year, especially when it comes to personalized products. You don't want to miss Q4. Last year, we did $200,000 in a single day on Black Friday. We did $140,000 in Cyber Monday. And with that, guys, I will see you in next week's video.